morning or good afternoon to everybody. Have you ever been to Dominica, Urs?
Yes, I have been in the last century, I have to say.
Okay. Then things have evolved a lot since 20 years ago.
Yeah.
So, as Urs made the introduction, I'm a Greek lawyer. I'm based in Greece. We have my law firm has offices in Dominica and in St. Lucia. We have licenses in Dominica and St. Lucia. We are also, as Kevin, a service provider. That means that we are direct contact for you for in order to file your applications. Apart from that, I'm also the past 10 years the consul of Dominica in Greece. We deal with all the Dominicans who are in the nearby countries, and that means that when you file through us your application or any associated service with Dominica, you have a direct access, you have a direct service, and everything is smooth and swift. So my presentation today will have two parts. We'll have one part, the Dominica program, and the second part will be how you can combine the Dominica program with the Greek residency. Okay, for those who do not know where is Dominica, Dominica is not the Dominican Republic. It is further up from Antigua. It is between the two French islands of Martinique and Guadeloupe. So Dominica is one of the two oldest citizenship programs. It has been established in 1993. Ever since, the program has evaluated. It does not have any infantile disease. It is a program that goes very swift. Once you apply, you can have an approval in the 50 days that follow a successful submission of your documents. So, recently the government has enacted some new changes. And I will focus on these changes now. The first and the major change is that you can add one of your siblings. That means that a main applicant can add his or her spouse's brother or sister. There is a limitation in the ages. The sibling can be up to 25 years old, single and with no kids. The second change is that there are no new fees for spouses. The third change is that there is no age restriction for parents who are dependents to the main applicant. Contrary to other Caribbean countries, Dominica accepted till now parents from 55 and above. Now we can see the circumstances and we can accept a parent who is less than 55 years old. So there is no restriction for the parents. And there are special rates for the additions of post-naturalization. Dominica is a program that runs now more than 30 years. So we have nationals who acquired the citizenship, let's say in the year 2000. They can add their spouse today, a new spouse, or they can add someone they did not add at the time they applied. So the investment options that are currently now in force is that you have two options. The first option is, like Kevin said for Antigua, there is a government fund, which is a pure donation. So Dominica, I will not use the term cheap that has been used before. I will use the word cost-effective. It's the most cost-effective program in the Caribbean. One single applicant can apply with $100,000. Now, as you may see on the screen, the new changes is that you can add your wife with $50,000 and you can add any... So the couple application is $150,000 and the family application is $175,000. And any person that exceeds the three dependents of the family application, you should add up 25,000. So a family of four, let's say a husband, a wife, and two kids, is 175,000. And should we add a father, a grandfather, we add another 25,000. Now, I understand that there is war over prices, but there is a Latin saying that says caveat emptor. That means that the buyer has to be aware. And what you see here in front of you is what you have to pay, and nothing more, nothing less. I'm referring to that Dominica gives you an unconditional citizenship, a passport for 10 years that you don't have to go back, you don't have to visit the island at any moment to solidify your citizenship or to get a 10-year passport. From day one, you are a citizen of Dominica, like any Dominican by birth. So, as I said, on any application, you can add now the brother of either the main applicant or of the spouse. There is another option, which is the real estate option. The real estate option is that you have to participate in one of the approved government, into one of the approved government projects. Dominica is very conscious on the investment of foreigners. That means that all projects in Dominica are being monitored. Your funds, your investment, which should not be less than 200,000, goes to an escrow account of the government and the developer. The money are being freed accordingly to the progress of the works. That means that at the end there is a project. We have seen many years in the past in the Caribbean that projects have never finished and people lost money. This is not the case. So in Dominica, apart from apart from purchasing a share in one of the projects, you still have to pay a small government fee. So this government fee varies to the number of members of your family. A single applicant is at 25,000, a family of four is 35,000, a family of up to six persons is 50, and a family of up to seven persons is 70. As I said, for the government fund, here also, you have the possibility from now on, from the 4th of July, to add your siblings, to add a sibling who has less than 25 years old. If the sibling is less than 18, the additional cost is 25,000. If he is between 18 and 25, it is 50,000. Just a parenthesis, it's only Dominica and Grenada who accept siblings in the Caribbean up to now. So amongst the things that were determined by this circular of the Citizenship by Advancement Unit is the definition of the dependent. The dependent is any dependent of the spouse or of the main applicant below 18. Of course, we include the spouse and the kids that are mentally disabled or have any sort of physical disability. The parents, as I said before, there is no restriction on the age now. And as I said, the siblings, the biological and the, and either they are biological or adopted. There was also certain adjustments that were made. As Kevin said, for Antigua, Antigua accepts kids up to 28 years old. Dominica accepts from 18 till 30. And we need to have them enrolled in a university, and we need to bring copies of this of their university cursus. So as I said, there is no age limitation for the parents. The new change is also the sworn affidavits of support. The main applicant has to file the application of support for his dependents. And there is a new change. that we had parents that were divorced, and one of the parents had the sole custody of the child. We needed both signatures in the past. Now, on the basis that the main applicant, the parent, has the sole custody, his sole signature will be necessary only for the application. Now we go to something that it's totally new. It's totally new for the Caribbean. It is what you can add. Let's say that you today apply by yourself with $110,000, $120,000, $130,000, and after five years or after 1 year, you're going to add people you did not include, or maybe you did not have, you were not married. So the newborn kids, the cost for adding a newborn kid that was born after you became Dominican, it's $500. This also goes if you adopt any kid. If you adopt any kid, the kid can become Dominican immediately. Now, before, when you wanted to add your wife, I'm very sorry that the screen is not clear here. When you add your wife after getting the citizenship, in the past you needed to have a new application. The government has been very conscious of this, and now the price in order to add your newlywed wife is 75,000. And 75,000 is not only for the main applicant who applies for his new wife, but the kids who were naturalized as kids in the past and now they're adults. When they get married, they can benefit from this provision and they can add their wives with $75,000. Of course, as you may see on the screen, you need to pay the $1,000 application processing fee, the due diligences, and all the accessory fees. Now there is a new provision. Let's say that today you have applied by yourself and you have 1 year in order to benefit from special prizes. If today, let's say the 30th of July, you have been Dominican, you have 1 year to add, and you should see the right hand side of the screen, to add your wife for 50,000, to add any dependent for 25,000, and to add a sibling either for 20 or 25,000. If the year lapses, then the prices become as on the left side. The spouse needs 75,000, and every dependent needs 50,000. Of course, with all these applications that are accessory applications to the main applicant, you need to pay the due diligence fees and application fees. So these are the new changes that have been installed since the first days of July. Now, as I said, the Dominica government is very conscious of the projects and of the real estate that the investors place their money. So in the screen, you have the finest example of a project that has been finished. It's a 6-star hotel. It's the Kempinski, which is in Portsmouth, and which is all the shares have been sold out, and it's currently functioning. It's a fully functional hotel in the north of Dominica. Eventually, the applicants may also opt for the Hilton, which is a very nice hotel, also on the Caribbean side of the island. We do have brochures for this project, and we can assist you to make any sort of investment in this project, which has extremely progressed. And last but not least, you have the Secret Bay, which is a very high-end hotel. It's luxury villas that are built near the near Portsmouth also. It has been recently awarded the first prize for the for being a luxury hotel. And should any body wants to contact us regarding the investment in this in any of these two hotels, we are very happy to assist you with any sort of information or clarification. So, as Kevin said before, what are the citizens' benefits? The benefits are the same, whether you opt for Antigua or whether you opt for Dominica. The changes are only minor. Of course, there is one difference, that Dominica gives you a 10-year passport, where Antigua gives you a 5-year passport. And we give an unconditional citizenship. We do have 140 countries visa-free. We do have also the tax-free status on the foreign income, the capital gains, and the estate tax. We do something which is more important also. We have confidentiality. The names of the persons who become citizens of Dominica are not published. There is no government gazette that comes out that anybody can consult. That means you have security. You have security not only for you, but you have also security for your assets. And as I said, it is the finest tool for a tax optimization. We will come later on to my presentation how you can use your new citizenship. Of course, you can have a visa for the US or Canada, and it's very relatively easy to get. We have many clients who get a 5-year visa immediately for the US. And as I said, there's absolute confidentiality, and there is no need for any sort of permanent residence. You don't have to fly to Dominica. So, Dominica, as I said, is one of the oldest programs. It has elaborated all the forms, and all the filing can be done online. We do it from the embassy here in Athens. Everything can be done online. No need to travel, especially in these hard times of COVID. So this is a very short presentation of the forms that you need in order to apply. So you have the form 12, you have the disclosure form, which is the backbone of your application. You have a fingerprint form where you have to put all your fingerprints in front of a police officer or a notary public or a lawyer. And you have the D3, which is a form that outlines your health status and has to be signed by a practicing doctor. And on the right-hand side of the screen, you have the D4, which is the contract that you have with the government of Dominica, stating the bank accounts of the government, where you have to send the money of your investment once and only you are approved. In Dominica, you just pay 1,000 application fee and the due diligence fees, which cannot exceed, for a big family, $20,000. Once you have been approved, there is a letter of comfort that is being issued that advises you that you have been approved, and then you are invited to pay. So this is a screenshot of the D1 form. It has all sort of the information regarding your family, regarding your financial status, where you have worked, where you have studied. This is a list of the documentation that you have to supply. We need passport copies, ID copies, driving licenses, birth certificate, marriage certificates, military service certificates, a detailed resume, one bank reference, bank statements, and police clearance from all the countries that you have lived. This is a screenshot of the online system. This is exactly the what we as service providers, as direct service providers and as agents, file your application. This is the exact screenshots of the online system. As you see, everything is detailed. And this is a screenshot of how we upload all your documentation. It's a screenshot of how we structure your application so that the examiner who vets your application and the due diligence company who runs a check on you will be able to do it thoroughly and in a quick way. So let's say that you have been approved and we are on the way for our passport. This is how Dominica passport was before 1978. As you may see, it was a British passport and it was stating State of Dominica. So I'll just show you something. It's the first time we saw it. It's the evolution of the passports. So this was the inside. It was all handwritten. As you may see, it's a very old passport dating 1974. This is the passport that was issued upon the independence of Dominica in 1978. In fact, this is a Russian client that acquired the citizenship back in 2000. And these are the current passports. The middle one is the current one. And on the right-hand side, we have Kevin and Urs, but if we can show it, you have the certificate of naturalization. This is your birth certificate. This is this is what you get when you have paid your government fund, you have paid your investment. This is what you get as proof that you have become Dominican. This is your new birth certificate, in a way. So, as I said, Dominica does not look only to attract clients and to get an investment. It is a new country. It is a new country for you, for your family, and for your next generation. Having a Dominican citizenship, you are entitled to apply for a driver's license. We can apply for your driver's license on the basis that you do have a valid one in the country that you live. So this is the application form. We can also get you a tax number. A tax number that shows that you are resident non-dom in Dominica and you have a tax number. We can eventually also get you a social security number. This is a multi-purpose identification card that the government hopes to have it issued in the next months. It will be like an identity card with a chip. So this brings an end to my Dominica presentation. So as I said, having a citizenship of Dominica, it gives you international mobility and it gives you also the way to planify the life, your life and the life of your family for the next generations. And as we are speaking of ETIAS is the system that the European Union is going to install in about 2 years, and it's going to apply for all countries, non-European countries, of course, who have visa-free for Europe. So whether you are American or you are Canadian or you are Antiguan or you are Dominican, this is going to apply for you. So you will have to apply online based on your Antigua or Dominican or American passport every 3 years in order to get a sort of a visa. This is brand new. This is something that people don't know, but from 2022, it will be effective. So how you can overrun? You can have a Dominican passport and you can apply for a Greek residence permit. I'm not going to focus a lot. I'm just going to make a lead in for our next webinar that will be in some days. So you have a Greek residence permit based on the purchase of a property, as the first speaker explained, with 250,000. The actual residence permit is what you see on the bottom of the page. I saw one of the questions. Yes, it is not only a property that leads you to the golden visa. You have also this possibility of investment. We are practicing lawyers. We are not promoters. We're not promoting a specific project. And the people who come to us want to have a free, independent advice on where they're going to buy, how they're going to buy. And we have dealt with many cases. And I understand that purchasing a property can have many other complications in the future. So there is a possibility of having just a deposit in a Greek bank of 400,000 euros, and you can get the same benefits. It does, you don't lose your money, you don't have to pay annual fees, you don't have to pay annual taxes. When you don't want it, you just take your money, you lose, of course, your golden visa. There is another possibility for people who have wealth or for people who can show a sort of passive income. We can arrange a residence visa that can be a residence permit that can be for 2 years, the initial period, and 3 years ever after the renewal. You need to show a passive income of 2,000 or have a deposit in a Greek bank or for the total amount of your stay in Greece. Recently, there is one change. In order to renew this residence visa, you need to have, for every calendar year, 6 months presence in Greece. So this is called the financial independent person's permit, and it can be more information can be obtained through our law firm. Recently, the Greek government has enacted the non-dom regime. For the non-dom regime, you transfer your tax residence in Greece. You need to have an investment of 500,000. You need to pay every year 100,000 flat fee on your worldwide income, and your tax obligations are extinct at this point. And for every dependent that you have to pay 20,000. Today only, the Greek government has enacted a 7% flat rate for foreign retired people to come and stay in Greece. So this will be a topic in our future webinar. So this brings us to an end, and I'm ready to entertain any of your questions.
Well, thank you, Christos, for the information about this Caribbean island, Dominica, and all the advantages it can offer. You mentioned, I think here from a question, there is certain confidentiality, how it is treated in the country. And the question is, what happens if a country signs an information sharing treaty later on? Will all the information not be shared?
We don't have such kinds of agreements.
I mean, perhaps we will have them in the future. Is there? No?
Listen, I will tell you the following thing. The program has been installed since 1993. Since up to today, we don't have such agreements.
Okay, good. Thank you. Then my question again, since I'm in the Middle East, how is it handled with people from the Middle Eastern area, Arabs, Iranians? Is it easy for them to get it?
The Middle East is one of the best markets for all these programs. Of course, we do not accept Iranians on the premises that they live in Iran. But if an Iranian he lives outside Iran for the past 10 years, then on a case-by-case basis, we may see this application.
And then there was a question concerning, you mentioned a birth certificate
that the naturalization certificate is assimilated to a birth certificate. It is your birth certificate as a Dominican. It is not a birth certificate let me explain to you. In order to renew your Dominican passport after the 10 years, you need to bring your original birth certificate, your certificate of naturalization, and your passport. These are the three elements in order to renew at any Dominican embassy around the world your passport.
Okay, very good. And in the passport, it will be still the old place of birth, which is mentioned. So if you are from Athens, it's mentioned Athens, or otherwise it's mentioned Damascus and so on.
It will mention Syria and Arab Republic.
Yeah, okay. Good.
It does not mention the place of birth. I mean, the actual place of birth. It states the country.
The country. Okay. And how is it with the health situation, hospital-wise? Is it quite good for Dominica, or they travel usually then to Florida or?
No. Actually, now the government has finished one of the big projects, the Queen Margaret Hospital. So I don't think that we have this medical migration.
Okay.
Except for specific cases.
Good. And let me see. Then a question. Can a person do a name change after the person gets a passport? Is it possible for some reason to change the name, or is that
you can eventually change the name under certain circumstances? I see that yes, it can be done through a judicial process. In any country, you can change the name. It's not specific to Dominica.
Okay, good. Thank you.
The only difference is sometimes I think that. In St. Kitts and in Antigua, when you change your name, the name appears as an alias on your passport.
Ah, okay.
You have this this major difference.
Yeah. Well, thanks a lot for the information.